Save Live, bringing you back to another Monotype Live. This time I'm gonna be laddering with fighting. Last video I made, it got copyrighted because I used music. And yeah, so, but hopefully I can bring you this video and still get some dubs with this fighting team. Yeah, I'm just gonna lead off with Infernape as it just gets a block here. He's probably just gonna take these two or three blocks from me. Here, he's probably gonna wanna click EQ, so I'm probably just gonna go out to Keldeo. These are my league mates right here. Damn. That Hydro Pump would have been able to 2-hit KO him, but no. It's Pokemon, so nothing you can do. Right here, he's probably just gonna drop a Draco on me. Or he could click Hydro. I could see him clicking Hydro too. I think I'm just gonna sack Infernape as I don't think it really does much this game. Besides just vacuum waving. It's actually broken by rocks and I have no defaulter. Yeah, so he does pick Dragon Pulse. Right here he has no fighting switching, so I'm just gonna pick Oyster as he's chase locked into Dragon Pulse. It does do 49, as he's probably gonna go for EQ. Oh, he goes for Waterfall again. So I get the free Secret Sword, killing something. And he does go into Azu. I don't want this thing setting up a Belly Drum, so I am just going to put Pika Sword. Alright, that's fine. He does just go straight up for the Aqua Jet. So, I'm going to bring out my Mega Medicham, and he's probably going to expect a Fake Out, but I'm going straight for the Thunder Punch. The Aqua Jet, that's fine. I will collect Mind Kill. As he goes out into Keldeo. It's looking like he straight up loses to Hawlucha, but I want to keep the fake out for the rain. I guess I'll sack Lucario here. As we live, but we get burnt. Alright, so I am going to just sub up here. He is Life Orb, so he's going to be taking this chip damage. He does go out into Poly. With Politoed, I can just click... I can just click High Jump Kick here. Just going to click SD here. As he stalled, which is fine. I'm gonna sub up, stall out a turn to rain, and I'm going to just play High Jump Kick here. The stall does knock me out, but this should be able to wrap up the game because he has no rain. And he's got Keldeo, the one thing that might have lived. Yeah, so this game is over. And I also just noticed that I'm not even on my Save Alive Live account, so that was highlighted. I'm at 1700s right now. Let's see. It could have updated if that was previous to the battle. Yeah, I'm at 1700s right now. I guess I could find another one for you guys on highlighter. It's a little bit more better on highlighter because, like, people also know what they're doing, so, like, you can make predictions and stuff based on, like, the plays that they should make. On low ladder, you really can't predict them as much because they can go for just about anything. It is taking a minute to find the game. And we do find another water on high ladder. So. Same thing as last time, I'm just gonna wanna lead off with Infernape here. Get up these rocks as soon as possible. He does Volt Switch, that's fine by me. Ooh, Thunder Wave. Good play on my opponent's part. He's probably just gonna go for Volt Switch here. I'm just gonna click Endeavor. Get off some chip damage on whatever he wants to go up to. As he does go out to Gyarados, I'm just gonna go into my Keldeo. I don't want this thing setting up on me. I'm just gonna click Scald here. As I do get the burn, which I was trying to go for, I'm gonna sack my Infernape here. Predicted that. Alright, so I am going to go out to Meteor as he pretty much punches holes through his team. Alright, he goes out to his Rotom, which I know that it is not, I know that it's not Scarfed. Does High Jump keep put Slow Blow and Key Punch on? Because if it does, I'm going for that. Let me type something real quick. Mega Medicam. Adamant. Slow Blow. Not Mega Slow Blow, calm down. High Jump Trick does do 33 to 95. And hold on. So with the combination of Stealth Rocks, well, there's a chance. I'm just gonna click it. If he doesn't go out to Slow Blow, so he takes that nice High Jump Kick. I'm assuming he's gonna wanna go for Key Wave here, but I really don't care because I'm gonna fire off a Dark Pulse with my Spec Lucario. Really touches his team. Alright, so he does have combo and this thing is a threat. I'm still gonna go for Dark Pulse. Try to whittle this thing down. I get the flinch, that's good on my part. He does go for Scald, so I am gonna be able to knock this thing out. As I get the chip damage on Keldeo, putting him in plus one close combat range from Heracross. He's probably just gonna go for Scald here. I'm gonna save my Lucario. I'm gonna go out to my Keldeo. true, as he does go for Secret Sword. There's no way that's bet, so I'm checking my Secret Sword. He's probably, I don't know what he is, because if he was, like, calm on, like, I would assume lefties are life orb, but... Oh, he's Scarf. Scarf Cardio, that's what he has. I don't want this thing belly drumming up, so I'm clicking Secret Sword regardless. Alright. And like last game, I'm just gonna click Thunder Punch and knock this thing out. Ooh, that's not a switch in, buddy. And he is gonna try to make a play on me, try to go out to a Swampert. I just click High Jump Kick because it's safe for me. It'll code the Slowbro, and it covered the Swampert switch as he did. And here I am just gonna Thunder Punch, and this should wrap up the game. GG to my opponent. So yeah, with with water, fighting can still beat it. Even though you don't have I don't have Breloom or Chestnut, it's still doable. Just have to play it the right way. I'm going to get back on my Fatal Eye. Okay. So. Now I can find another one with fighting. We do get the advantage as we face Dark. I think Grimsley is in Lotus, so he is in my lead. I want to get a Brox as soon as possible, so I think I'm just going to lead Infernape. Yeah, he leads Hoopa, which is pretty nice for me. I'm just going to get up my rocks. As he Hyper Space Holds, I'm fine with that. Just going to fire off a vacuum and get off some chip damage on this thing. What do I want to do here? I don't want him able to defog. I could go out to a Nutty, but I'm pretty sure he's going to go hard into Sableye. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna go Medi, and I'm gonna click Thunder Punch, just in case he goes Manny, but if he goes Sableye, I'm pretty sure he still takes a lot. This is Adamant Mega Manny thing. And then after, I'm hoping he'll be in BP lane. Now, let's talk how much that does. Thanks for that much. Try to keep the BP defense. Ooh, as he does go out to Mandibuzz, so he will not be defogging this game. Okay. I could keep this around, but Weavile outspeeds Tyranitar pretty much this. I mean, I could kill Titar, but I could also kill it with the rest of my team. Fire Shark, it dies to Sucker Punch. And Sableye obviously walls it. So, I'm just gonna take Bullet Punch and get up some shit damage on this thing. And now that he doesn't have Mandibuzz, I can just freely kick Mega Horn and collect my kill. As he goes out to Buy Shark, which I'm okay with, because Mega Horn still collects the kill. And I collect my Moxie boost. He's going out to Sableye, which is his only option. I'm going to go out to Keldeo. As he whisks. Now I collect my kill with Hydro Pump. Titar, you bulky monster. I'm pretty sure that thing's Assault Vest, taking 49 from the Specs Hydro. So this should be going down to the next one. Of course I missed. It's going to connect and it does 26%. He goes out to Weavile and clicks Ice Shell. I'm just gonna go out to my Heracross and click Mega Horn, collect my kill, and click Mega Horn again on the Sableye. Really don't care if he burns me, because I can Earth Bomb with the next one. And this should be GG. As I'm gonna find another battle guy. As I get another advantage, Dark is coming back. The rise of Dark. Same thing as last time, I always want to lead Infernape, as he is my Focus Sash lead. Get up rocks, and if he chooses to go out Sableye, you know, I can just Fire Blast it. So there's the Weavile. If he has a Fake Out set, I still live anything after, so not really worried about it. Just get up my rocks this time. He does go Sableye, which gives me a chance to Fire Blast it. And I'm just gonna Fire Blast again. If he stacks this, is nice for me, because then I'm like, close combat from Heracross to sweep. So he doesn't choose to stack it, he goes up to Sharpedo. That takes a hell of a lot from this Fire Blast, so 64, putting him in Vacuum Wave. I'm assuming he's probably like Aqua Jet or something the way he went into this. Nope, as Vacuum Wave does connect, and that's that thing up. Gonna freak out again. I'm just clicking Vacuum Wave. Knocking Weavile out. And I'm just gonna click Vacuum Wave again. Get off some chip. He is he could be Specs. Yeah, I think he is Specs. I could just go Keldeo and collect my kill. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna click Hydro here. Ooh, he stacks that. And now I'm just gonna sack Keldeo. If he goes for a Hyper Space Hole, it's fine on me. Because now So just go to another Medicham. You click Thunder Punch and you select Marker. Click Thunder Punch again. Quick BP, knock this thing out. And that should be GG. These games are quick, so I'm gonna find one more. As we do ladder into Ghost. Okay. Yeah, Ghost is pretty annoying. Oh my god. Just the combination of Dual Blade and Jellicent and Sableye, and he has Cough Rodriguez. This is some type of like stall Ghost. I'm pretty sure this Gengar is like a substitute. And Golurk is obviously his Sash Rocker. I'm predicting him to want to lead off with his Sash Rocker. Just gonna lead my Infernape and get a Brox. As he does lead off a Gengar. I'm just gonna pick Rocks and see what he wants to go for. He does fire off a Sludge Bomb when he gets the burn. I'm just gonna pick Fire Blaster as he knocks it out. Now I could just go out to Lucario here and click Dark Pulse. Pretty sure he's gonna switch out. Or he just stays in and lets me hit the spin. He is sad. I kinda wanna save this thing. We just kind of went one time. I guess I could sack this though, because Keldeo pretty much does the same job as him. He just hits harder. So, time to go out to my Alucha and click Acrobatics. If he goes out to Dual Blade, it's fine because I'll go straight into Keldeo. Yeah, right here, I'm gonna want to go straight out into Keldeo. As he FDs, I'm gonna click Sculpt. As he chooses not to go Jellicent, I really don't know why. I'm just gonna go out to Medicham, as he's probably just gonna click Sculpt. Ooh, Shadow Ball, that thing. Ooh. That boy just tossing on my neck. So he's probably like some offensive Jellicent. I don't know what he is. Just because of the simple fact that he didn't go out to this on the Dual Blade, and he pulled me with Shadow Ball. I'm gonna go into Keldeo and click Hydro and see if he is water absorbed. Well, I do miss as he clicks Dazzling Gleam. Wow. I'm gonna go out to this and click Mega Horn. Yeah, I can't really touch this. Even if I went for Stone Edge, he could just go to, Yeah, he is first party, so he wasn't water absorbed. Fuck, man. Yeah, we are gonna take this loss unless he misses the wish, which he doesn't. Yeah, this is GG. Yeah, this is GG, yeah. Yeah, so that's gonna be the end of this live. I think, yeah, 1569. We are coming close to 1600. 1569. Wait, I could have went down because of that loss. Huh? Let's see. Oh yeah, 1541. We were 1569, but that ghost lost brought us down. Yep, right here, 326. Next live, I'll try to hit 1500, and we'll work from there. See you guys. Fade Y out. Oh, look at my two up. They're right next to each other. Yeah, I guess.